is broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
The Methodist Church, St. Martin's Circuit, welcomes you to another of the Leeward Islands District devotions. I am your host, Patmore Henry, serving as Superintendent Minister of the Circuit. During the past week, it was our sincere joy to have shared with you on the theme, Our Methodist Heritage, Yesterday, Today, and the Future. Our sub-theme for this morning is A New Direction. Let us worship God. Come, praise the Lord with all your heart and soul. Let our voices raise in a powerful song of praise and thanksgiving. I invite us now to share in our theme song, A Charge to Keep I Have.
A charge to keep I have, a goal to glorify, a never dying soul to save, and living for the sky, to serve the present age.
Amen. Let us continue with our opening prayer for today. Let us pray. Father God, you have created this day with all the glorious opportunities for us to experience the fullness of life. Fill us, O God, with gratitude. Lord, we want to follow you wherever you live. Reach out to us this day, stirring our souls and spirits with the winds of your power, that we may faithfully be your disciples. For we ask this in no other name, but in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Give God thanks as our youth share in this reading.
I am Jemiah James of the Phillipsburg Methodist Congregation. The scripture reading is taken from the Gospel of Luke chapter 9, verse 57 through 62. As they were going along the road, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus said to him, "Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." To another he said, "Follow me." But he said, "Lord, first let me go and bury my father." But Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their own dead, but as for you, go and proclaim the kingdom of God." Another said, "I will follow you, Lord, but let me first say farewell to those at my home." Jesus said to him, No one who puts a hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise be to God.
Let us prepare our hearts as we share in our meditation for today. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, glorify your name and allow your Holy Spirit, O Lord God, to accompany these words as we seek, O Father, to be stirred in a new direction. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Is it possible that our membership is suffering from what is called commitment phobia? Is it possible that we are not committed to being followers of Jesus Christ and by extension not committed fully in being members of the Methodist Church? When we say that we are members of the Methodist Church, what do we mean? Is it a sentimental phrase? Is it just having one's name on the membership list and attaching oneself to a church institution for the purpose of ecclesiastical benefits? On the other hand, I am persuaded to think that there is no doubt that some Methodist members are Christians who faithfully attend worship, are physically present at church fellowship, and are people who have heard the gospel proclaimed in various formats. But yet, I think it is true to say that there are some who have not made any commitment to being evangelists, and therefore, by extension, are not involved in harvesting souls for the kingdom of God. Somehow, there seems to be a disconnect in seeing our Christian duties and responsibilities as those of one who is a follower of Jesus Christ. As followers of Jesus Christ, Methodists are obligated to love one another, which obligates us to share the good news of Jesus Christ with fervor. Yet, too many find it difficult to commit oneself, talents, and resources for the advancement of the kingdom of God. Mark Dever, in his book, 9 Marks of a Healthy Church, suggests that commitment phobia is the fear that in promising to do something good, for we will miss out on getting something even better. This itself is ironic because the Christian is called to the best life anyone could ever experience. Perhaps then the phobia is not really wanting to have a better life or hoping to get a life better than the Christian life, but rather giving priority to Jesus Christ or devoting ourselves to Christ while developing and maintaining a strong commitment to Christ. So how does the scripture passage read, help us in addressing commitment phobia? In each of the 3 examples provided in Luke chapter 9, verse 57 to 62, we see potential followers of Christ hindered by fear and insecurity. In the passage, we encounter 2 men who volunteer to be Jesus' followers, and one whom Jesus calls to follow him. These 3 men all believe that following Jesus was a good thing to do. 2 of them express their own desire to follow him, But while they wanted to follow Jesus, it was not the most important thing for them. Friends, following Jesus must be more important than our personal comfort. Following Jesus is not just an important thing. It's the most important thing you can ever do in your life. It is not just part of our lives Jesus Christ wants. He wants to be, as we will say, the hub of our life. Everything ought to revolve around Jesus and his kingdom purpose. You see, our career goals or civic responsibilities must not be priority in our lives, but rather must be secondary to the will of God and his kingdom purpose. Your family life must be centered on following Jesus Christ and serving him. Your spare time is not your own to do what you like or what you please, but rather it must be yielded to Jesus Christ and his purpose for your life. When Jesus Christ is the sole purpose for your living, then we are totally committed to him. Is this your reality? Christian friends, following Christ requires that we devote everything and all that we have and are to him, or nothing at all. Yes, give him all or nothing at all. It is not a part-time commitment, because there is no part-time Christianity. Jesus is saying in the strongest possible terms that following him must come before every responsibility we have, be it family, social duties, or personal responsibilities. It is important to realize that the scripture passage is not just directed to those who are considering or have considered full-time Christian ministry or service, but rather, the passage is addressed to everyone who would consider being a follower of Jesus Christ or a disciple. It is applicable to all members of the church. It is applicable to our youth as well, especially some who may wish to say, well, I am young and I want to be free to enjoy myself. Or it is applicable as well to parents who see the church and church activities as secondary to whatever their child is called to do at school, but yet they will encourage that child to participate in social activities and sports, somehow giving the impression that these are more important than being active participants in the church or to be committed to the things of God in the church. So then, my brother, my sister, rising above commitment phobia, it is my view, is the new direction that we must take if our membership is to increase and if the MCCA is to survive. We cannot consider the things of God as secondary to other things that we do. There is no shortcut. It is not optional. There is no alternative to total commitment to Jesus Christ and being a disciple of his. We cannot keep one foot in the world just in case things do not work out in the kingdom of God. Oh no, it is total commitment. If we believe that God is Jehovah Jireh, then we should depend on him for our provision and not rely on numbers or lottery or casino or any other agency of gambling for our survival. Do you understand what I'm saying this morning? Our practice in what we believe must reflect where our heart is in our commitment to Jesus Christ. And I wish to say to us as well, just as there is no part-time Christianity, there is also no part-time Methodist. We are either committed to the ideas and the beliefs of what the Methodist Church practices and believes, or we are not. The same way we are either committed to Jesus Christ, or we are not. If the Lord is God, then let us worship him. Let us worship him in all that we think, speak, or do, in the lifestyle that we live. We cannot put down God today and take it up tomorrow and feel that all is well. And so therefore then, may God's Holy Spirit help us to overcome our commitment phobia and to be fully committed to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, forgive us when we choose to put our priorities before committing to you. Have mercy and forgive us. May we hear and receive your call to follow you and help us not to have any excuses or fear in committing to you. This we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. May we now share then in our closing hymn, "All to Jesus I Surrender, All to Him I Freely Give." Surrender all. It was the privilege and pleasure of the St. Maarten Circuit to have fellowshipped with you these past few days in this Leeward Island District devotional. And we pray God's blessing upon you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you his peace. Do have a wonderful day, a blessed weekend, and a glorious time tomorrow, worshiping the Lord. Amen.
The Lord. Lord lift his countenance upon us.